Hi guys, and welcome to Dinosaur Valley State Park. My name is Ranger Zach, and we're here at the dinosaur capital of Texas to check out some amazing and ancient dinosaur tracks. Now, standing next to me, you may have noticed Rex and Bronto the Brontosaurus. These two guys were made for the 1964 World's Fair in New York City and donated to the park to help welcome visitors. While they aren't the actual dinosaurs that made our tracks that we're about to go see, they do help visitors get an idea of the huge and immense size that dinosaurs used to be. So let's head on down to the Paluxy River and check out some tracks that are 113 million years old. Let's go!
113 million years ago. That's a long time. So did this land look the same then as it does today? Well, if I was standing right here, and if you were standing right here in this spot 113 million years ago, you would have been standing on the edge of a beach. The hills that we have, the valley that goes through, the river, the plants, the animals, none of the things that we have today existed back when the dinosaurs were making their footprints. Back then, 113 million years ago, this entire area was a muddy and marshy beach.
All right, y'all, we have made it down to the Paluxy River here at Dinosaur Valley State Park. Now, we're at one of the many track sites here in the park. We call this track site the ballroom track site. We call it the ballroom because there are so many different tracks here going every which direction that it looks like the dinosaurs must have been dancing. We're after one type of track in particular. The type of track we're looking at is this guy right here. This dinosaur track belongs to a dinosaur we call Acrocanthosaurus. Acrocanthosaurus belonged to a group of dinosaurs called theropods. T-Rex was a theropod, Velociraptor was a theropod, Allosaurus is a theropod. These are all very similar style dinosaurs. They stood on two legs, had three great big old toes, tiny short little stubby arms, big old head and a big old tail to balance them out. These guys all ate the same type of food. They all had sharp teeth, all had sharp claws that helped them get this food. Now, what type of food do you think they might have eaten? Plants or animals? Animals, you're exactly right. With those sharp teeth and those claws, they ate other animals. And if you just eat other animals, we call you a carnivore. Now, Acrocanthosaurus, the dinosaur that made these tracks, was big. He stood up to 20 feet tall. That's as tall as a two-story house. And he wasn't light either. He weighed up to 7 tons. That's as much as a full-grown elephant. 20 foot tall and 7-ton dinosaur. Acrocanthosaurus here was huge. Now, we're gonna travel to a different track site, the main track site, and we're gonna check out a different type of dinosaur there. But this dinosaur wasn't a meat eater. He ate something else. Let's check it out. All right, so we've made it over here to the main track site here at Dinosaur Valley State Park. And around me, you can see Acrocanthosaurus tracks like we just talked about. But we're not after Acrocanthosaurus. We're after something bigger. Much bigger. Much, much bigger. We're after a dinosaur called Sauroposeidon. Now, Sauroposeidon was huge. This is a dinosaur that's very similar to Brontosaurus that you may know. Now, like Brontosaurus, he stood on four legs, had a long neck and a long tail. And like Brontosaurus, he ate the same thing. What do you think Brontosaurus and Sauroposeidon ate? Plants or animals? Plants, you're exactly right. Sauroposeidon was a herbivore, and herbivores just eat plants. Now, Sauroposeidon was huge. If you thought Acrocanthosaurus was big at 20 foot tall and 7 tons, Sauroposeidon is going to knock your socks off. Sauroposeidon weighed up to 44 tons. That's 6 whole elephants. 6 elephants! That's how much this guy weighed. He was tall, too. Maybe the tallest dinosaur to ever walk the earth. He was 60 foot tall. That's as tall as a 6-story building. Just absolutely huge. And next to me, you can see his tracks. Here, you can see his back foot. Here, you can see his front foot. Notice how the two are very different, but also very huge. His back foot is so big, I could probably fit my entire body in just that one footprint. One of the tallest dinosaurs to ever walk the Earth, Sauroposeidon. So you may be asking yourself, how are these tracks made if they're in solid rock? Well, the rock wasn't always solid. It used to be mud. Remember, this whole area used to be a muddy, marshy beach. And when the dinosaurs were walking around here, they would step in that mud and leave their footprint behind. Now, you and I have likely stepped in mud making our own footprints and our own tracks. Here around the park, you can find deer tracks, raccoon tracks, and plenty of human tracks. But these tracks won't last for as long as the dinosaur tracks have. How come? Well, the trick to that is that after the dinosaur tracks made their footprints, it was quickly covered up. And by covering up the tracks, it protected it from all outside forces. Now, more and more layers would eventually cover up those layers and cover up those layers until there's so many layers on top of the tracks and so much pressure squeezing down on it that mud started to turn into rock or lithify, leaving the tracks that you and I can see today. Today, we've explored some of the many footprints here at Dinosaur Valley State Park. We've seen dinosaur tracks from Acrocanthosaurus and from Sauroposeidon, two of the many dinosaurs that used to once roam this land we now call Dinosaur Valley State Park. And while their time with us has come to an end, yours and mine is just beginning. So come on out to Dinosaur Valley State Park and explore some of the hundreds of dinosaur tracks we have here in the river. For Dinosaur Valley State Park, I'm Ranger Zach. Y'all come visit us and have a great day.